Hello, my name is Ronson Monroe McDowell. I am the CEO and president of Ronson Originals Pictures and Videos, located in Youngstown, Ohio. Today is a special day. I wanted to give a virtual shout out and happy birthday wish to none other than MC Light. Now, this is a book that I was able to purchase from her when she came to Youngstown State University. And as you can see on the inside, she signed it for me. I became familiarized with MC Light in the late 80s, I believe it was 1989, when I was able to buy my first ever CD. It happened to be her CD, Light as a Rock. I believe somewhere in the 80s also, I saw my first female music video in Fayetteville, North Carolina, where my brother Sherrall lives. And so I was really taken away by her lyrics, by her music, and by her performance. So today is her special day. I do have some video footage of her when she came to Youngstown State University. I was not given permission to record everything, but I was told that I would have permission to have clips. So I will share a little bit of clips of when she was speaking at Youngstown State University in honor for her birthday, which is today. So shout out to you, MC Light. I thank God that I got an opportunity to meet you. I had prayed to meet you all those years back. And so dreams do come true. God bless you and have a very blessed birthday today and many, many more.
Good evening. How y'all doing? It is a pleasure to be here with you on this cold, cold evening. Thank you so much for coming out. I know you could have been bundled up somewhere getting a nap or studying or something of that effect. So thank you so much for being here. Of course, I have some notes because I like to stay on track. I said, how many creative people we have in the house? All right, well, you know, we tend to steer all over the place sometimes. So I just want to stay focused for you all this evening so perhaps you can get some jewels that you can take away. Good evening, and thank you for this incredible honor among such an esteemed group of fighters. I know we got some activists in the room, some humanitarians and some fighters. You're fighting for something, whether it's to live or to stand up for someone else. I know that we have some fighters in the room, and I stand amongst the 21st century of the next leaders that will come into the space and take charge and move this nation into the place that we should be. I hope we have some leaders in there. How many leaders we got in the house? Okay, great. And we all know to lead, you gotta be a good follower as well. But my mother, the first thing she instilled in me at a very early age was to dream big. To dream big. No small vision will do. To dream big. And in order to do that, sometimes you have to be exposed. It's all about exposure to what is different. I remember growing up, you know, going outside to play was just the number one thing. Then when I conquered the block, it was like, can I go further out? Can I see what my community looks like? And then going to school, it was like, oh, okay, I get to see this whole world that exists between where I live and my school. And so for me, the important thing that my mother gave me was exposure. And so at that juncture, I knew I wanted to get on stage. I didn't know how, I didn't know what I was going to do once I got there, but I knew I wanted the microphone. And so I knew that growing up, and I'm sure like many of you, some of the artists, you don't even really understand why you like them or why you have a love for them, because your siblings or your parents may have introduced you to some music, right? But in Spanish Harlem, where my cousins lived with my grandmother, my Nana, that is where I heard hip hop. I heard the Treacherous Three, which if you didn't know, one of those members of Kumo D was a part of that group. I listened to the early stages of Curtis Blow. I listened to Sha-Rock and who came from the Funky Four Plus One More. She was the first female MC I ever heard on the microphone. And that was just a little bit of a taste of what was happening in Harlem. And so I come from Brooklyn. So in Brooklyn is where all the Jamaicans, all of the Caribbean folks, Bahamians, Trinidadians, Guyanese, all of, it's a melting pot, Haiti. Everybody was there, and so we listened to reggae in Brooklyn. You should always have friends around you that are supportive of your dreams, that can hold you accountable to what it is that you're trying to build. And once you say it, if they see you going the opposite way of where you said you want to be, they can knock you on the shoulder and say, hey, you said you wanted that, not that. So remember to surround yourself with people who care, basically, is what I'm saying.